Hello everyone, welcome to another Trailmakers video. It's your boy Kosmo Cat, and today we are going to be building something cool, guys. Now I really want to start actually exploring and, you know, getting all the artifacts and, well, basically just trying to see what this new map is all about. However, I also have this urge to build a rowboat mechanism. Ever since we got the oars in the game, I've been wanting to build a boat that basically rows by itself. Not necessarily rows by itself, I'm still going to be, you know, doing all the inputs, but I want it to be a mechanism that essentially rows. Now, before I go what I think is the easy route and do it with sensors, I actually want to try and do it mechanically. Now, I'd be lying if I said I didn't already try to prototype something like this last night because, well, I wanted to be prepared for the video, guys. So let me show you what I actually came up with, or rather, didn't come up with. So up first is this abomination, guys. I tried to turn rotational motion into the motion that an oar would make while you're rowing the boat. However, there are some mechanical limitations. Here, let me show you what happens when I do this. This was never going to work. As you guys can see, the components are actually trying to stretch, and that is because in real life, you wouldn't really have a mechanical component locking the oar to the boat like that. In real life, you have a shackle that the oar sits in and kind of, you know, pivots inside of. This was never going to work. It does some funky stuff, and even though it tries to make the rowing motion, it's just, it's nonsense. There we go. And that is not really the game's fault, because I'm trying to build, you know, something that, well, just wouldn't even really work in real life. However, so obviously we don't have enough degrees of freedom on that mechanism, and I don't actually know how to achieve those degrees of freedom while still using components that are locked together. The only way that I could think of is to have pistons that are in a relaxed state that can expand and contract as the whole creation moves. However, pistons just do not have a relaxed state in this game. So if you place a piston down, there is nothing that basically says that I can decrease the strength and just have it be moving in and out freely based on another component's movement. So now that we got that out of the way, let me show you my second prototype that I tried to make work. There we go, guys. Abomination number two. And I'm really glad that I did all this stuff off camera simply because, well, it doesn't work that well. So don't be mad at me. I know I did some stuff off camera, but I wanted to make sure I don't come to you guys as a total embarrassment. Now, obviously, this mechanism is a bit bulkier, actually a lot bulkier. And having this on a rowboat, I don't know, even if this worked, I'd be like, that's too bulky. That's just too bulky. So let's see how this actually works. I've got a cam setup essentially, and as you can see, it's trying to stretch those ball joints. I was like, hey, why am I using turning hinges when I can literally use a ball joint, just one ball joint, and it should do the exact same thing that I wanted to do. However, we run into the exact same issue, guys. When we're going up here, you can see that ball joint is trying to stretch, and it's doing some really funky stuff. So even though we technically achieved a rowing motion, kind of, we are still very much limited by physical components trying to stretch out past their, you know, nominal state. This would be easily solved by a piston that can move up and down freely without any inputs based on other mechanical components' motions. However, as we just covered, that is not possible. Now, I did try to make my cam smaller, like so. Let me just quickly recreate that for you guys. I was basically like, hey, maybe my motion is a little bit too rash. You know, maybe we're trying to move this thing a little bit too much. Well, let's see how that works out. As you can see, guys, same deal. Basically the exact same deal, and we're getting some unwanted effects, let's call it that. Now, before we get into the solution that I think will actually work, I'm going to try something first, guys. So as you guys may know, a rowboat actually has these like shackles that hold the oar in a certain spot around the edge of the boat. That's what I'm going to try and do right now by creating a shackle just like that that sits around my oar and see if the game's, I guess, hitboxes allow me to recreate the oar motion with mechanical components. Because I'm pretty sure I can do it with sensors, but I really want to try and do it mechanically. So let's give it the good old college try and try and make it work mechanically once more. Alrighty, and there we go, guys. There is my shackle that's supposed to hold my oar from sliding all over the place. Now, here's the kicker. Basically, there's a lot of space between the ore and the shackle perimeter, so we might have to use some regular blocks and sacrifice some aesthetics if that ends up working. But let's give it a go. Perfect. So the ore is resting on the shackle. That is good. Let's give it a go. Oh my goodness. Oh no, it popped out. It popped out. I was gonna say, guys, it's actually kind of working. Let's just try that again. Wow. Okay. You know what? Let's do a bit of a test build. You know, this does seem to work pretty decent. I didn't expect that. Okay, game. You're throwing me a bit of a wild card here. Not how I expected this video to go, but I guess this is where we're at. Oh man, the nice thing about this is that I can row forwards or backwards. Interesting. Okay, well, I'm going to build a test rig. Oh boy, it just keeps popping out. Let's see if, before we do a test rig, let's actually see if we can make this hitbox a little bit tighter, which will in turn hopefully keep our ore a little more stable. Don't know if it'll work, but it's worth a try, right? That's what we're here for, guys. Some good old experimenting. Oh, it does not like that. No, nope, hates that. So we actually need the larger space in between. That, I mean, makes sense, I guess. Makes sense. Alrighty, guys. So let's build a test rig for this. And I'm going to build a test rig. Here is the test rig. Now, you're probably noticing the same thing that I am, and it's that this is very, very bulky and wide. That's the only thing that bugs me about it. I think it might actually work, but in terms of, like, scale realism, this is a crazy big mechanism, you know? Now, granted, we could shorten some things up. I still think it would be quite bulky, you know? But let's give it a go, and let's see how it works. Drag it out into the ocean. Perfect. And drop it down. Are we even gonna float? Oh, boy, I was scared we weren't even gonna float. All right, guys, place your bets. What do you think is gonna happen? We're already floating, apparently, but let's try rowing. Oh, no. Oh no, it popped out like immediately. I think I know what the issue might be though. These guys are a little bit too close to this pivot right here. So let's try and move them over. That should be a little bit better. Oh, but we're not going anywhere. We're moving at 2 kilometers an hour and I don't think that is... Okay, let's go in the other direction. Can we do that? Okay, Oh boy. So we got the rowing mechanism down. I mean, that's basically the rowing mechanism, you know? But it does not like life right now. It hates life. They are a little bit out of sync as well. I'm curious to know how they get out of sync. What can I say, guys? We're rowing, but we ain't going nowhere. So it's kind of bittersweet. I am a little bit glad that this isn't working as well as I had hoped. Simply because I do want to build a slightly more compact mechanism that will actually rely on sensors to function and control some of the motion. So let's go back to the shore, definitely not by our own means, and try and build that. It's really interesting, in this expansion, you can't use your, like, laser jetpack thing for very long. I almost want to have, like, a little bar that shows me the charge and when it's fully recharged, because check it out, right? I can go up, kind of. It's much weaker than in the other maps. And then I fall down, and if I try again... Yeah, you see, it's much shorter, so it definitely seems to have some kind of recharge time. It would be cool if there was an indicator for that. But hey, I guess it makes sense, because this way you can't just, like, fly up to the top of that mountain and find a secret place. You know, you actually have to build something to get up there. I didn't really like that in Stranded in Space, you didn't have this function at all, because sometimes you just want to, like, get over an obstacle, you know? So it's nice that they gave you, like, a limited function of it. I do like that. But enough random observations, let's build this rowing mechanism. Alrighty, guys, so here is the basic idea. Here's what I'm thinking. So So basically the idea is that I will be controlling the up and down motion of the oar, and the sensors are going to do the rest for me. The idea behind this is that when I lower the oar, one of the sensors gets triggered and moves the rotating servo to drag the oar through the water. Now when I press the button for raising up the oar, it triggers the other sensor, and I really hope I set these up right. I always get confused setting up the tilt sensors, but I think I set it up right this time. I think I got lucky. What happens when you lift the oar up is it actually returns the servo, the rotating servo, back to, I guess you could call it, the starting position. So let's quickly take a look. So as you can see, this guy right here is controlled by A and D. For now, I figured I would limit it to 10 degrees of movement, but we can always change that. Now this rotating servo right here doesn't actually have any direct inputs, but it does have inputs from the sensors here, as you can see. One is outputting a negative one, the other is outputting a one, so theoretically we should get the action that we need from it. So let's give it a go. So if I press D, okay, we lifted the oar up and we brought it back. Now what if I press A? Okay, I mean, so far so good, guys. Let's try that again. D, raise the oar, bring it back, lower the oar, bring it forward. Interesting. Now, I wonder if the speed of this is a little bit too fast. Let's do that to 0.5. And maybe this guy right here is a little bit too fast as well. Let's bring that down to 1. Let's give that a go. Okay. Guys, this might actually work. It does require me to press 2 keys, you know, to row, but hey, rowing is basically 2 motions, you know, front and back. You know, you're pulling, and then you're pushing the oars away from you. You're pulling, and you're pushing the oars away from you. Alrighty, so I think it's only fair that we build a test rig for this as well. I'm really curious to see how this rows, so let's do that. Alrighty, guys, here we are, test rig number 2. I have mirrored the units, so technically, we should be good. Technically, we should be good. I put some oars on there, so let's give it a go. Something else that I did actually is I increased the angle to 20. I just felt like the oars were a little bit too shallow before that. Let's just give this guy a go. I'm really excited, and I have high hopes that this may actually work. Press A. O. D. Interesting. A again. Oh my god. Okay, that lightning was cool, but That's not why I said that. This is awesome, guys. I think we're actually rowing. Oh my goodness. It works. It works. It works. Dude, that's so cool. And I can go fast too. Like, look at this. 20 kilometers an hour. Oh, this is awesome. It's working out great. One thing that I actually might want to fix up is the angles of my tilt sensors, because I just realized if there are waves, my tilt sensors are going to be affected by that, so I need to find an angle that is, you know, still being detected, but also doesn't get triggered by the boat being, you know, off tilt. Hope I explained that correctly, but I'm pretty sure you guys are noticing the same flaw that I am in this design. However, I am also noticing that it works very well. Yo, this is so cool. Okay, well, guys, I think it's time to build that boat that I wanted to build. I actually want to build a dragon boat. Now, a dragon boat in real life actually takes like 20 to 40 people to operate, I think. And there is a rudder because, well, clearly I can't steer right now, right? I can only go straight. But dragon boats have a rudder, so I think that's going to be the saving grace for this design. However, it would be really cool if I could, well, you know, both row backwards and forwards and also be able to steer. But for now, I just want to build a boat that goes straight and steers with a rudder just like a dragon boat would. I actually just noticed a little glitch where my oars moved by themselves because they got triggered by the waves. I do think I'm gonna need to adjust the angles because I feel like when the wave hits me, my oars get a little bit out of sync simply because one is getting triggered already ahead of time. But that's okay. I don't want to get too far out. I don't want to end up in the vortex again. So let's go back. Now the nice thing is that I think I only need these two units and they can control all of the oars on either side, which should make things a whole lot easier, a lot less bulky, a lot less ugly. And yeah, let's just go, guys. Let's just build this thing. I'm so excited. We'll be right back.
Alrighty, guys, it has been a hot minute. I've been doing this for so long, just trying to get the aesthetics to look good, and I'm actually really happy with how it ended up looking. So, without further ado, everybody meet Bert the Dragon Boat. This is Bert. Bert is a dragon. He's a very festive dragon. He's a happy dragon. He's got a short tail, though. He's got a stubby tail. But you know what? It makes Bert special. So don't make fun of Bert's tail. But guys, I'm so pumped to give this a try. I did do a little bit of testing just to make sure that everything works okay, like halfway through the build. But really, this is going to be the ultimate test right now. Now, obviously, everything is already synced together. I do have a rudder in the back. Now, I know typically there would be a person, sitting in the back with an offset oar and steering, or maybe like an actual like rudder type mechanism. But I figured I want to have it down the center just so that we're, you know, nicely balanced and, we're all good there. And I think this thing is good to go for its maiden voyage, guys. I am so excited. Now, here's a little thing that I did too with Bert here. Bert can get angry. Arr! I put a fire pit into Bert's mouth, so if he wants to, he can breathe fire. And Bert also has some exhaust ports, so you know he can vent all his anger through the back as well. But guys, let's give this a go and see if this actually works. Oh my goodness, it actually works. Okay, can we try steer? I think I need to turn off seat controls. That's right. Oh man, we're moving forward. We're moving forward against the current. That's amazing. Are we actually moving forward though? Wow, it's having a hard time fighting the current. You see that, guys? That's crazy. Let's actually try turning a bit here. Just so maybe we can like get in line with the current. Because I feel like I'm not going anywhere. Yeah, I'm totally not going anywhere. Okay, let's just go this way. Nope. Okay, let's just go this way. Perfect. All right, we're good. I don't know what happened there. Oh no, Bert's tipping. Guys, this is awesome. I didn't think I'd be able to make a rowing mechanism that works this well, you know? This seems to work quite well. Steering leaves something to be desired. I almost feel like we might need to like put bigger fins for steering or something or other, because we're not steering too good. Check it out from the front. Look at that. Bert just going to town. I love it. It's actually going pretty quick, guys. Now, I haven't adjusted my sensors yet. That might be something that I need to do, maybe later on. I'm not going to do it right now. I'll be honest with you guys. I've been building this thing for so long, and I just want to enjoy playing with it. I think all the fine-tuning can come later. Not a big deal. The important stuff is here, so that's good. I am, however, not happy with my turning, so I'm gonna go back, and I'm going to try to see if I can, maybe put some bigger fins on this thing. Like one of these bad boys. That's actually much better. We're actually maneuvering now, guys. Before, I was like, this is not gonna work out. Look at this. We can actually go where we want to go. This is awesome. I want to get the front view, you know? Bert's so happy all the time. I just want to watch him. Just want to watch him do his thing. It's so cool. Oh, guys, I cannot believe that I was able to make a working rowboat. It would have been really cool if I could have made it mechanically, but think how much bulkier this would have been as a fully mechanical system. Like, I'm already at the complexity limit with 10 or 9, I think 9 oars on either side. Oh no, I did do 10. So cool. I actually did it fairly realistically in that sense, because like I said, you have about, you know, 20 to 40 people piloting a dragon boat. And this is it. This is basically that. So I'm really happy, guys. And everything moves in unison and it turns. Let's see if Bert can take us back to shore here. Now, like I said, I do have to adjust my sensors. Yeah, see, like that's happening because the boat got tilted over by a wave. You know, that's gonna happen, guys. That's gonna happen unless I adjust my values. Which, like I said, I just don't have the energy to do that right now. I hope that doesn't come off as, like, lazy sounding or something, but I honestly just had a long day. I had to call the cops on 2 separate people today at work, and it's just been... It's been a day. Let's just say that. It's been a day. But this is awesome. I want to try and make it back to shore. We're not doing too well, but I think we'll be okay. As long as Bert can actually fight the current here, it'll be okay. Oh boy, getting messed up by the waves again. Come on, Bert, you can do it. You can do it, Bert. I believe in you, Bert. Bert, your head's on fire. I almost need to, like, oh man, the waves are messing me up. The waves are messing me up bad. I almost need to, like, oh, come on, waves, chill. Let me talk, waves. I almost need to make it so that there's, like, two sets of oars so that you're basically, like, moving forward at all times. Because what happens here, if you guys notice, once we're not going to be getting messed up by the waves again, if you guys notice, we're speeding up to like 20 kilometers an hour almost, and then we're slowing right back down to almost zero on the, I guess, the return stroke. So it'd be really cool to remake this, but have it so that the oars are a little more spaced apart, or maybe just like two sets of oars that basically keep the boat moving forward at all times. That'd be really neat. Oh man, it's a struggle to go against the current, guys. It's a struggle. I don't know what to tell you. Bert, you did well, buddy. I'm proud of you. Bert, don't sink, Bert. Oh my goodness, the waves are really messing it up. Such a bad ending to the video, considering it was working so well, and now I'm like in the rough water, and it's completely screwing me over. Actually, you know what? Let's do this. And here we are, guys. Good old danger zone. No waves here, none of that. I'm actually curious if we can... Nope, we can adjust the time of day, and that's about it. So I guess weather is only on that other map, which makes sense. Makes sense. This map was not meant to have waves and all that stuff. Come on, Bert. Into the ocean, Bert. Let's try some other views. Look at this first-person view. Oh, man. This is awesome. Oh, this is neat, guys. I love this. This makes me really happy. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. I might make more improvements to this thing, but I think I proved what I wanted to prove, and that is I can make a rowboat mechanism in Trailmakers with the new oars. And it makes me really happy. I'm really glad that I was able to do this. I've been thinking about this for a couple of days. I was really excited to do this. Let's just leave it at that. But in any case, guys, if you did enjoy the video, definitely let me know in the comments below. I love hearing what you guys think about my builds. I love hearing your guys' ideas as well. If you did enjoy the video, definitely leave a like down below. It helps the video be seen by other people. The algorithm does its magic. And if you guys aren't subscribed yet, subscribe for more awesome content. Check out my merch, kosmogear.com. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye! To infinity and beyond, Bert! Or something like that.